right field?
Well, that's where I think people can do their own sorting if you have the Excel, right? Because that way, right, this is by vendor type, but if you had the same file, I think any of the individuals would be able to say, okay, I'll just sort by lakes, and that way you can kind of tell what the groupings are, because it tends, personally, I think you need it in PDF in order for it to go into the attachment, but maybe we leave it as, if the council has any, if they want to delve into the details and be able to sort it, you can contact Jason to get the Excel file. Now, the agenda comes out on Friday, and if you've got questions over the weekend, you wouldn't be able to contact them to Monday. So it may just be, when you have this item, provide it to, in the normal fashion, but also give the Excel file, and here, when you send out the overall PDF, she can attach the Excel file. And I think that would allow the members to do some of the sorting and grouping, see if that kind of helps. Because I think it's kind of been kind of hunting packets, like, ooh, what's this one, what's this one? It's a big file, we have a lot of money.
Absolutely, the file layout can be in Excel as well, too.
Thank you.
Yes?
Chief?
Sorry, Chief.
Oh.
Chief, question on DLS supplies.
Okay.
I missed the question.
Chair, I know quite a few invoices for DLS supplies, and I'm wondering, would it be who was to purchase in a larger quantity, where we wouldn't have
we try to, when we purchase through the chair, we try to get enough quantity, but also not too much, because there is an expiration date on some of this stuff. We don't want to go back and have to throw away or donate it somewhere. So we try to do it so that we have just enough to get by without it expiring.
Okay. I understand.
You know, when you took all those vendors, KMS, Lynn Medical, MedTech, those are kind of the three places we get the medical supplies through.
Do those local, or how do you order that stuff?
Lynn's local, KMS is local, but they actually have a driver that delivers stuff. MedTech is kind of on the other side, in the west coast of the country.
Okay, but they deliver to the central station?
They don't deliver, well, they have it delivered, shipping it.
What's your timeline on delivery?
Sometimes, if it's a rush order, we can get it overnighted. Usually it's about 2 or 3 days. And with KMS and Lynn, it's usually next day because it's not that ordered.
My concern was whether or not we ever have a situation where you do not have an item that you need in the ambulances.
This happened, one or two times, but we also have department, we have a hospital we have a great relationship with. We can usually get something to borrow. We have an ambulance company with another great relationship. We can borrow something until we get it.
Okay. All right. Just concerned. That's all.
Any other questions? All right. 7.8. My takeaway on it is we've only had 2 months under our belts. And, any questions from the council? Hearing none. 7.10 was removed. Actually, I believe then 7.11 would have to be removed because they're related. Or are we? What are we doing here?
Chair, good evening. I would prefer to leave them in. I am going to bring the trucks back, but I guess they go hand in hand. If the trucks don't get approved, and bring those back for future meeting, then the plows would kind of not serve a purpose. I'm hopeful we can budget for the trucks. We are going to go out to bid with the trucks into the competitive bid process. Hopefully that will qualify the local vendor to put in a good bid where we could use them. But the plows do coordinate with the trucks.
And we did bid, and it appears
approved, then obviously plows will get ordered.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Ram.
The Chair, Mr. Ulin, the important thing is, as far as these plows are, the winter coming on, what happens if they disappear and we can't get them? That would be a concern of mine.
You want to top us?
Well, yeah, I don't know if they're pushing the package. These would hook to the current vehicle we have, so the, you know, if something breaks in our fleet that we currently have, we could transfer one of these plows on. They are interchangeable with our current fleet.
Mr. Chairman, why did they pull it?
Through the chair, you were explaining, basically it was kind of a, these are 22 models, correct? And then 23. But it was kind of a word, well, we'll honor the 22 prices, but we didn't have that written. It wasn't written. So I didn't want to bring that, and then all of a sudden we get the, hey, no, they're more than what we expected, and then we would have to come and say, well, no, there's a price increase. So we wanted to make sure that everything was written down, that he would guarantee the prices of what they are here. So I wasn't comfortable with that, so we decided to pull that. But we should be able to, once we get that written document, we'll bring this right back to you.
Now, you're looking at 2 weeks' time, and in that 2 weeks' time, how many prices could increases might they have?
Through the chair, I think, like, you know, the plows could be gone, so I get that. But the vehicles are there. We just wanted a written document, a signed written document, saying that he would honor this price for the 2022s, right? 23s, right. He said, but sometimes when they take them, they can say, well, wait a minute, now I can sell these for more. So we didn't want to have to come back to you and say, well, wait a minute, this guy didn't hold his prices. We wanted written, in written form, saying that they would, these are going to be the prices no matter when they get them. Am I correct, Jason?
Yeah. Just one item note. Because we had two items for Berger Chevrolet, right? We had the police towels. The police towels was in the state contract, 2022 manufacturer year. Those were competitively bid out. We have all the documentation. The 2023 year model is not in that contract, that state contract. So we thought it wasn't to review. So we said, you know what? There's no competitiveness on that pricing. Let's yank it. Let's take it up to bid ourselves. And that's what we're going to do with the silver house. So that's kind of the short of it all, but yes, there was some communication with Berger on 2023 models that, you know, didn't link it to the contracts. They're like, okay, well, we're going to bid them out because we need that competitive pricing for the 2023 year. So.
Mr. Chairman, how long of a duration is it going to take to get these, you know, on site and outfitted or they're usable for your purpose?
Through the chair. So I've been advised, and now mind you, this is just speaking to one vendor, they do not have these on the lot. So honestly, with what I've seen with vehicle trends, it can be 2 months, it can be 8 months. It depends on how
they may never get built.
Yeah, they don't ever give you an exact date. They give you when the bin's created, when it goes into production. I believe they give you an email, but right now, vehicle is such a, I don't know if I'll have these for winter. If I bring them back to the second meeting in October, it's going to be a tough. I doubt they're going to find two of these exact vehicles in the state that ever built.
The reality is, I think the marketplace right now has gone to 50% build to order, and the other 50% is you know, what's on the lots. But that's going to have to change how we do business. Because if you don't place the order right at the beginning, you're fine. You've got to kind of place in line, and you've got to think 6-8 months in advance of when you need the product.
You're talking budgets too.
Right, it crosses budgets. It's that's just the reality of the marketplace.
Mr. Chairman, is there any action we can take tonight to go ahead and approve this purchase, you know, pending the paperwork?
Well, we don't approve anything tonight.
Yeah, genuinely.
By tomorrow, if they came and changed, but the recommendation right now is to take 7.10.
Yeah, I would say we take it off because the reality is they're not in inventory right now. They're into the 23 production cycle, not the 22. So either way, we're ordering these, and this gives a great opportunity, as you guys were speaking earlier to. We will go to our local vendors, and we will urge them to really consider bidding